I'm Carsten Becker. I'm the head of electronics at PT Scientist, and we're a private company working on the first commercial missions to the moon.
You're creating a lunar lander and a rover.
Yes.
Isn't that expensive? Like, where's the money coming from?
So in the beginning, you know, this was really a lot of private funding and small investors. We caught the interest of Audi. They wanted to support something very innovative and challenge their engineers to think about problems they never have faced before. For example, if every kilogram that we are able to shave off the rover, or any hardware essentially, is worth millions. Mm-hmm. And so Audi was helping us to reduce the weight from the third generation rover, which was weighing about 45 kilograms, down to 35 kilograms. If you are into math, then you will find out that this translates into 20 million euros of potential payload that we can sell.
And this is all in service of possibly in the future, you know, having more missions, colonies, things like that. This is all interesting science that can be done towards that goal, right?
Yeah, so for example, if you want to build a moon village, as the head of the European Space Agency calls it, you want to know which materials you want to use. You know, one of the most important questions is, can we use duct tape and other materials? You know, how long does the MLI, the blankets, last? And so those are very interesting questions that can be answered from taking a look at what is standing on the moon for 45 years now. Mm-hmm. We have built a lot of hardware, but it's not like many people imagine that you're working on parts all the time. So you're ordering and then you put it together. Mm-hmm. But actually, it's a lot of engineering, and 2 or 3 months you put it together and then you qualify it and off you go.
This is another interesting part of the testing, is that obviously if you're making a rover, you have to be able to test it on something that's like lunar regolith. And that's what we have here, the regolith.
Yeah, so what's really cool about this part is it's not just some sand that we stole from a beach. This is what you will find below the first layer of dust.
One of the lightweight innovations you guys have come up with is these amazing tires, if you can really call them that. This is all hardware, it's incredibly light. And so is this like machined aluminum or something like that?
So this is 3D printed aluminum.
Oh, it's is it sintered?
Yes, exactly, yes. Yeah. Yeah, it's really cool stuff because it's extremely sturdy, extremely lightweight. And the best part is, it's just one part. It's unlike the wheels we had before, which were a bit smaller. They were made from different parts that had to be screwed together. So you're eliminating points of failure, you're reducing the weight, and also pretty cool stuff.
In your sort of mission statement, you talk about both making space more accessible and using reusable parts and off-the-shelf parts. How much can really be off-the-shelf? What do you mean by reusable? And it still sounds like it costs millions of dollars, so how is it more accessible?
We use a lot of components off the shelf, which is something that is not very likely to be seen in other space missions. And the reason why we are getting away with this is because our mission is quite short. Essentially, our mission could be done in as quickly as 2 weeks. And this is why we get away with using automotive parts or industrial-grade components.
They're not meant to last for like 500 miles in 3 years.
Exactly, yes.
How close are you to actually putting together a working lander with rovers built in and everything?
So the goal is to launch at about the third quarter of 2019.